Okay, students, now I am going to tell you about CRO. So in CRO, you can find out so many operations can be performed. Mainly we will go with your frequency measurement and amplitude measurement. So it will take a lot of time to get mastery over the controls of CRO. But somehow in this video, I am just going to tell you how a layman can use a CRO in effective way. So the red button I am pressing is power button. So once you press this power button, it will take some time to turn on. So now you can see that your device is on and you are getting some waveform on this, because I have connected some input to this. So I am taking this input out. So now when your CRO is not on, you will find out that a straight line is there. Okay. So your CRO is having two channels. So you can see this is the second channel, and simultaneously you can have two different waveforms on CRO. So normally we go for one waveform. So what you have to do is, here you can see a button is there, dual button. So you press it, now you will get one channel. So you can also have any one channel amongst two. So you can select here from here which channel you can. So this is the right channel, this is the channel 1, this is channel 2, this is channel 1. So from here you can get the channel being selected. So now I have selected channel 1. So now this is how you can view the waveform. So whatever output I am getting from function generator, I am just displaying that onto your function generator. Now there are several functions. Suppose your system got misaligned. So now you want to align it. What you have to do is, and why we want aligning this, so I am just focusing on your CRO. Here you can see that basically your you're having a plus sign over here. Plus sign over here. You can see. This is your system. You are having a plus sign over here. So your entire screen is being divided into small box, and each box is having some value. I will have a separate video on that in the near future. So next is, sometimes it may happen that your waveform is altered like this. So you want to align it to the normal position, because normal position is like this, this and this. So if it is not leveled, so you can use this particular button to level to a particular platform. Now, sometimes you want to change the X position. So you can do it using this button. So this is for Y position. And if you want to change it for X position, then you can use it like this. So using this, you can move your signal like this in X position. Sometimes your signal keeps on moving from here to here, then you can make your signal stationary using this particular button. Also, this device can be used to measure frequency or amplitude. So if suppose your amplitude is very small like this, so it is not giving you any sort of information. So what you can do, you can change the scale. Here you can see, when you focus on this, here you can see various scales are there. Various scales are there. So scales are from your 5 millivolts, then 10 millivolts, 20 millivolts, 50 millivolts, 1 millivolt, 2 millivolt, and so on. Sorry, 0.1 volt, 0.2 volt, 0.5 volt, 1 volt, 2 volt, and up to your 20 volts. So in this way, you can change the scale. And why we actually change the scale? Because we want to get a very good information about the signal. So this is how you can change the scale. So it is just the change of the scale. We are not doing anything with the actual value. You are just changing the scale. That means if your scale is earlier it is 5 volts. So I am making it 2 volts, 2 volts for small box. Now it making it 5 volts, and if it this now this is your 5 volts. So 5 volts for this small box. Okay, so a detailed video will be there how you are actually calculating the VDOs. So now I have changed this to 1 volt. So you can see actually your magnitude is not increasing. We are actually changing the scale. So this is for your vertical axis. Sometimes we want your time axis to be compressed. Suppose you are getting signal output like this. So you are not able to read it. What is the actual frequency or time period for your signal is behaving? So in such case, you need to change the scale. So again, I will be showing you the scale. Here you can see, if you focus on this, here you can see we are having different scales. Here 0.2 seconds, 0.1 seconds, and then 50 milliseconds up to 2 milliseconds, and then 0.1 milliseconds. Then your scale is in microseconds, and right from 5 microseconds to 50 microseconds. So these are the scales in which you can actually change the scale of your view. So now I will show you what is the impact when you actually change the view. So here you can see I am changing the scale. So earlier it is in 5 milliseconds. So now I am changing it, and now I am making it around 1 microsecond. So you can see clearly changing the scale is actually changing the way we are looking at the waveforms. So this is a quite a good thing and quite helpful for analyzing. In the meanwhile, I will also tell you how your function generator is being used for changing different functions. So here you can see I am having this particular function, this function button. Here you can see this is a function button, and in this on this function button, if I change it, I will get a different sort of waveforms. So here you can see what is the impact when I actually change the function. So I change the function, so now it becomes triangular, it becomes square wave, it becomes sawtooth wave, and again it becomes a pulse, then it becomes a DC, and then it becomes a sinusoidal signal. Also, if I change the amplitude, you can see from the amplitude button which I am rotating right now, here you can see changing the amplitude button actually increasing or decreasing the amplitude. So here when I am changing this, I am changing the scale, but here your amplitude is actually changed. Your amplitude is actually being changed. So sometimes you want frequency to be varied, so you vary the frequency. So I am decreasing the frequency like this. Here you can see decrease in frequency means less number of cycles per second and so on. So I further decrease the frequency. So here you can see less number of cycles per second. So this is how you can use function generator and your CRO for various experiments. So function generator is basically used to generate the input, and CRO is actually being used to check out when your particular input is applied to the system, what sort of output you are getting. Sometimes during your experiments, you want to measure the phase. With phase difference between two signals, then you can use this particular button XY. So right now you are having this symbol. So if there is phase change, you will have different sort of symbol between your inputs and outputs. So that shape actually provides you the information whether the phase is more than 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree. So those patterns are called Lissajous patterns, and I will tell you about them in the near future whenever it is required. So right now, if you are having any questions, you can post in the comment box, and you can also ask during the live class. I will clarify your queries, but most of the things has been completed. Yeah, one more thing is there. Suppose you are having an output waveform like this, and here you will find out a button minus 20 dB and minus 20 dB here. So if I press them, actually my signal is attenuated. So this is my signal being provided to the CRO. Now your signal is attenuated. And if I further press minus 20 dB, so my signal is further attenuated. So sometimes it is required your signal to be attenuated, so that we can do with the help of these two buttons. So that's all for the day. Thank you very much. Have a nice learning.